Hey guys, it's Dave from Mind Your Bushcraft. It's been a while since I've made a video, so today I thought that I'd make a short little video on fire straws, show you guys how to make them. Fire straw is simply a regular old straw packed full of cotton, and cotton is mixed with petroleum jelly. I'll show you here. We got a regular old straw. You buy these anywhere. I think I got these at the dollar store. I don't know where you live, but where we live, the dollar stores are phenomenal for carrying just about everything. So basically what you do is you have your straw and you take some form of cotton. Unfortunately, I don't have any cotton balls today. I wish I did so I could show you, but everybody knows what cotton balls are. Say I'm using these cleaning pads. Girls use these for taking makeup off or this and that. I have these hanging around because I particularly like using these for making char cloth. They're 100% cotton and they're flat. They're perfect for making char cloth, which I will show in another video. But for today's purposes, we're going to use them. And what I've done is I've just taken a small one here, and I've basically just torn it apart like so. And they'll work just as good as a cotton ball. Basically torn it apart, made a little ball of it. You can see I already had one pre-made. So we'll put them aside because I wanted to show you that you can use just about any cotton. Here's a cotton swab. And basically you just use your fingernails to kind of go around it and slowly pull the cotton off of it. Same with the other side. It's not the easiest thing in the world to do. I'll explain my thought process afterwards in regards to the cotton swabs. Next you want to do is you either take your cotton balls or your cotton swab pieces, whichever you're going to use. You want to put them into a bowl or a container for mixing. You want to take the petroleum jelly, and it doesn't matter what brand name you use, it's all basically the same. So this is just a cheapy brand name. Possibly pick this up at the dollar store, I'm not sure. You want to take a mixing utensil. I'm using a nail. The reason I'm using this nail is because it is approximately the same diameter as the straw. So, because we're going to be packing the cotton swabs into the straw in a little bit. So you just want to take some petroleum jelly, just get some out of the container. Take your mixing bowl and you just want to kind of get it in there and mix it around. So feel free to get your hands dirty. It's just petroleum jelly, so not gonna harm you in any way or form. So mix it around, get it into the cotton really well. Might want to have a cloth handy or something to wipe your hands off with after you're done. It's cold out today. Nearing the end of, well, I guess we're in the middle of November. So mix it in there really well. And back in the bowl. Towel here and wipe your hands off. Alright. Then you want to take a pair of scissors. And you just want to cut, say, approximately 2 inches. So say a 2-inch straw. I think that's about good. These are basically for emergency situations. Any other time that I would use something like this would be if I was in a hurry to start a fire, say in a wet situation, or I just was really hungry and wanted to get my campfire going. Otherwise, I would try and use as natural means as I possibly could, whether it be a bow or whether it be fire steel. I consider stuff like this as an emergency situation. So we'll start out with a two inch approximately. What you want to do is you want to take a pair of needle-nose pliers and you want to clamp down one end like so. All right. Then you want to take a lighter. I like Bic. Bic's a reliable lighter. And you just want to light the end like so, just ever so slightly. Just melt it a little bit. Oops. Melts a little bit so it stays together. Like so. Then you want to take your little bits that you've mixed. You want to try to feed them in to the end of the straw. See if we can get them in there. Then we take our nail, which is approximately the diameter of the straw, and we start feeding it little bits at a time into the straw, like so. I want to pack it down in there, right to the end. Take another little bit, feed it on in there. You guys can get creative with this, you know, try it my way and see how that works for you. Maybe you can think of a better way of doing this, or better product to use, or just a different way. Get creative. This is part of the fun of survival and bushcraft. Coming up with your own unique ideas and sharing them. You just keep packing it in there. Keep packing it in until basically at the end. Probably fit a little bit more in there. More in there, and then I'm just gonna clean off the end of the straw a little bit. Clean my hands off too. Then what you want to do again is same thing we did at the beginning. You just want to grab the end of the straw. With your needle nose pliers. Oh, slipping. Petroleum jelly is working. And grab your trusty Bic lighter. And just melt the end a little bit there. Melt a little bit more. There you have it. Fire straw. Now you have cotton mixed with petroleum, which will burn really well, inside a waterproof container. And these will float. These are waterproof. These are excellent little lightweight containers, and they don't take up any space in your pack. And what you can do is, a lot of guys have these little tins. They carry fire steels in them. And now you can carry your little fire straw. Another thing I like to carry in my tin is a little strip of tire rubber. These are great. They burn for a long time. They're perfect in wet conditions for starting fires. You can get these off of old tires, or you can go to Canadian Tire and buy yourself a replacement tire. They sell rubber tires approximately this big, and they're for their wheelbarrow replacement tires, and they sell them for about $3. You buy one of them, a $3 wheelbarrow replacement tire, and you got all the rubber in the world. But you just cut them up into little strips, and they're waterproof, obviously, and you can light them up, and they'll burn for a long, long time. They light up fairly easy. I'm not going to show you here in the shop. I'll show you when we go outside. But they light up fairly easy, and they burn for quite some time. You use one of these to start a fire if stuff happens to be really wet outside. So, all right. Well, let's go outside, and I'll show you how to open up your fire straw and use it. See you in a minute. Alright guys, we're outside now by the fire pit, so I can show you how to use your fire straw. I wanted to show you, I was talking earlier about the replacement tire, and this is it here. This is a wheelbarrow replacement tire. There's nothing to it. I actually bought one. Thought my dog would play with it, but it's not very interesting in it at all. So, on with the fire steel. Let's see if we can get you onto it here. All right. So, basically you just take your fire steel and your bushcraft knife. You want to be careful while you're doing this, and just cut the straw open. Like I said, you want to be very, very careful when you're doing this. You don't want to cut your fingers. So you open up the straw and pull out just enough. Pull out just enough. Pull a little bit more here of the cotton out of the straw, and then you just kind of want to fan it out a little bit, open it up, this stuff is great because you can use your Bic lighter, or you can use your it's my dog in the background barking at his shadow. That's what he does. But open it up anyway. You can use a Bic lighter to light it up, or you can use your fire steel. Hopefully you can see this. It's kind of hard to tell because the sun is in my way and I can't see the viewer all that well. There you go. Should be able to see that. Like I said, you can use a Bic lighter, or you can use your fire steel. I'm gonna use my fire steel.
And there you go.
Burns surprisingly well. While that's burning, I'm going to show you, may as well, got a flame. I'm going to show you the rubber and how easily it lights up and how long it burns as well. You don't want to breathe in the fumes coming off the rubber. Like I said, it's for emergency situations where, you know, it's so wet out that it's hard to light anything else up. Oops, that went out. So let's get some more out of our straw here. Again, be really careful when you're doing this. The last thing you want to do is cut your fingers. So we'll just, again, we'll open that up. And I apologize for the noise of the cars if you can hear that. My backyard is right behind a major road. So we'll just put that back up there. And use the trusty fire steeler on it again. There we go. Apparently this time it's not gonna light. There we go. So let's get that piece of rubber off an old tire. And we'll light that up. Shelter it a little bit from the wind. Hopefully you can see that. Camera here. See if you can see that flame. Yep, there you go. You can see that rubber burns pretty good. And like I said, it's perfect for really wet conditions. If you don't have anything else you can find to start your fire with, a piece of rubber is absolutely perfect. So, get on with the video again, and I'll show you. So once you open your straw up, and you've used your cotton and whatnot, basically what you want to do is you just want to pinch the end. Again, you want to be careful because I'm assuming you're not going to have any needle-nose pliers out in the wilderness, unless, of course, you have a multi-tool, but hopefully you can see this. Just kind of melt the end. Be careful, don't burn your fingers. And just like that, it's closed up again, ready for use for the next time, back in its waterproof container. So, like I said, this is just one way or one idea of doing it. If you guys can come up with other ways of doing it or something clever, just let me know. Thanks for watching. Bye.